Previously, you moved the segments around the sequence that had no synced audio. You'll now see how Autodesk Smoke works with synced audio using sync groups. This selection contains a mixture of video-only segments as well as media with synced audio. Currently, if you select any segment in the sequence, Smoke will only highlight the segment that you have selected. To select the entire sync group, you go to the gear menu at the bottom of the sequence and open it. Choose the group title and the selected option labeled Link Selection. You can now see that all the synced segments become selected as well. In Autodesk Smoke, this is called a sync group. This sync group selection is permanent on the selected segments unless you manually ungroup them. With Link Selection enabled, you can move, trim, and edit the sync group segments together, and this should ensure that the segments never go out of sync. However, moving other individual segments in the sequence, you could potentially knock something out of sync. For example, I'll turn Ripple on, and I'll adjust the tail of this clip before the sync group segment. You can see that the audio segments of the sync group display the frame indicators telling you how many frames the audio is out of sync with the video. At this point, you can do one of two things. You can manually shift the audio to match back with the video segment, and the indicators will adjust accordingly. Alternatively, you can select the sync group and right-click on it. In the pop-up menu, you can choose Resync. This function will automatically slip the audio segments back into sync with the video without altering the edit. Another issue that can come up is when sync sound is slightly offset from the video. For example, audio that was captured during the filming of a faraway subject could create a slight delay between the action and the sound. The sync indicators think that the audio and video are in sync, although you know better. You can turn off the link selection from the gear menu and move the specific audio until it is in sync with the video. Of course, the sync indicators will tell you that the audio is out of sync. However, if you turn on link selection and right-click on the audio segments, you can choose Reset from the pop-up menu. This will reset the sync connection in the sync group between the video and the audio. The video and audio are now in sync, and the sync group now accepts the new offset as the correct sync between the segments. One other consideration to bear in mind when editing with sync video and audio are the other tracks. For instance, you would like to edit a video-only cutaway between the segments containing audio and video on the tracks. If you press the Insert Edit button, you will see how the targeted video track gets shifted down, but the other video and audio segments do not. This throws the whole sequence out of sync in all aspects. To maintain the sync of the entire sequence, you would use the sync locking buttons located in the patch panel. You can click individual sync locks or hold down Shift and click the sync locks to apply to all video tracks and then apply to all audio tracks. Pressing the insert button will insert the video segment into the timeline and all the other tracks will be inserted with a gap of equal length to maintain the sequence sync. In the next video, we'll be splicing, extracting, lifting, and subclipping.